From Stone Angel Brewing, this is Selkirk Blonde Stout. Yes, Blonde Stout. Two words that I didn't expect to see together. Inspired by Scottish shortbread, this blonde oatmeal dessert stout is brewed without roast and finished with jaggery sugar. Lord Selkirk, who brought many Scots to Manitoba, was a Douglas. His family tartan used on this can lends the blue to the official Manitoba tartan. Hmm. That's not what I was expecting at all. It's interesting. I'll have to see if it grows on me or not. First mailbag item is one times tester. Mo test equipment. Some sort of a module. That looks like a buck and or boost converter. The capacitor on the input side is 50 volt and on the output side is 35 volt, so it might be a buck. New DC-DC 3 amp adjustable buck module, LM2596, regulated 24 volts to 12 or 5 or 3 volts, or anything in between, because it's an adjustable output. I got this one from Poe-28. I got it at auction for 58 cents. Obviously, this auction's closed, so I'm going to link you to something else on their channel. It's the same part, just a different listing. What else is there to say about it? The input range is from 3.2 up to 40 volts, and the output range is 1.25 volts up to 35 volts. The input has to be 1.5 volts higher than the output. Reasonable. 2.5 amps. If you want to go higher, please add a heat sink.
Low hops, I don't mind. Lack of malt, not my favorite idea. Oh well, it was worth a try. Next in, we have one times tester. Could it be another of exactly the same thing? It is. It's the same buck converter. Okay. Did that come from the same seller? No, it didn't. Not this time. Okay.
Same description again, DC to DC 3 amp buck adjustable buck module, LM2596, regulated 24, blah, blah, blah. This one I got at auction for 74 cents from CSDF5963. And yeah, the shipping labels were different, so I think they are actually different stores, even though the listings are carbon copies of each other. And again, since this was an old auction, I'm going to link you to something more current on their store as well.
Well, that's two mailbags in a row that have got identical things. Maybe I should pre-check some of these things before I start recording. Nah, where's the fun in that? This says one times modules and one times modules. I hope it's not more of the same buck converters. It isn't. One of them's in a bag, one of them's not. It's got a sticker on it. These are clearly an RF module of some sort. These are ESP8266EX. These are specifically the ESP01 module, which is an ESP266 core, but it's only got a couple of GPIO pins, which are essentially the serial pins. I don't have the breakout right handy, but basically these can be used to add Wi-Fi connectivity to an otherwise non-Wi-Fi capable module. Now, why would you want to add a Wi-Fi capability to another board rather than just using something like the D1 or the D1 Mini or a standard ESP12, which has a handful of GPIO pins that you can use? Well, the obvious answer is you'd use it when you need a whole shitload of GPIO, more than any of these guys can handle. In this case, you just hook this guy up to TX and RX of, say, the Mega, and then you've got all 53 GPIOs available, minus the two serial ports, and you can still add Wi-Fi capability to it. That's one reason. That's the main reason that I grabbed these, other than just for to have a complete collection of everything I could possibly ever need and no, not enough time in my life to use. But
ESP8266 ESP-01S serial Wi-Fi wireless transceiver module, send receive AP+STA. That's access point or station. I got these from DIY Electronic. Currently, they're selling them for $2.66. I got these two at separate auctions that ended about half an hour apart, and for each one, I paid $1.64 each with free shipping. So these things are a little bit tricky to program just because you have to jumper pins and whatnot to deal with them, but it's not that bad. They are a 3.3-volt device, as are all the ESP266 range. They are Wi-Fi because that's exactly what they're supposed to do. They have UART on them and I2C and a few other things if you care to use them as standalone processors, which you can do. But that's not their main claim to fame.
Next in, we have one time something and one time something else in Chinese characters. There's one, there's the other. Are they both the same? Well, they're not exactly the same. They both appear to be current measuring toroids. The coil itself seems to be pretty much the same. One's got lettering on it, one doesn't. But this one is just the coil. This one has, looks like some amplification or threshold detection or something like that on it. It's an LM358. It's an op amp. Okay. What else we got on there? Looks like an LED and just a bunch of other passives. Okay. To the listing.
Clearly both of these came from the seller. CZB6721960. 5/20/30 amp. Blah, blah, blah. Current sensor module for Arduino. There's a whole bunch of them in the listing. The two that I got is this number one, which was $1.61. And the number two, which was $2.99. So the number one can measure AC currents less than 5 amps. Okay, rated input current 5 amps, rated output current 5 milliamps. Okay, and it's a 1,000-to-1 transformer. It claims to have a 3,000-volt insulation breakdown. That's useful. The second one has a high-precision op-amp circuit board to do accurate sampling. Module can measure within 5 amp corresponding output to analog quality. These translations suck. I can't tell exactly what they're going to do. So I'll have to experiment with them. I have a couple of applications where I want to measure current and report it using an ESP or something similar. So that's what these are for, but I'll have to experiment and tinker with them, which should be fun.
And the last thing in, power supply step-down module. Ooh, I do like those. Even though I already got a couple of smaller ones today, this is obviously a Big Brother one. In a box yet. That should protect it from damage. Oh, wow. And more packaging. Oh, hello. Okay, this is, where's the part number? This is a D3806, which is the big brother of this one, which is, I think, a 3603, if I remember correctly. But this guy is just a buck converter, good for 3 amps. This one is a buck or boost, or buck and boost converter, good for up to 6 amps. Input there, output there, and basically the same adjustment control panel as this. I mean, identical. It's also got an output for a fan. There you can see a current shunt. Lots of heat sinking going on, some very beefy inductors there. Oh, that little control board is on headers. That's neat. So I could mount that somewhere else and put this in a convenient location closer. That should be interesting. Oh, that's intriguing. TXD and RXD. Can I communicate with this using UART or something? That would be really cool.
D3806, CNC DC constant current power supply step up, step down module, volt and ammeter. I got this one from Hong.2. top, who doesn't sell it anymore. But when I bought it, I paid $24.16 with free shipping. And since that guy doesn't sell it anymore, I am going to link you to this search. We'll just look at the listing from one random seller here. Digital display, constant voltage and constant current. Constant voltage, constant current and output LED. That's all the same as the smaller one that I've got. Adjustable output voltage and current accurately. Manual switch voltage, current, etc. Parameters, yeah. You can set it whether to automatically output or not after you turn it on. You can adjust the display to either stay static on what you set it to, or the display can toggle between current and voltage. Input voltage between 10 and 40 volts. Input current up to 8 amps. Output voltage between 0 and 38 volts. And it doesn't care which of the or where in that input range, because it will buck and or boost. Output current 6 amps, so it's it will absorb some power and eject a bit of heat, but that's to be expected. It claims to be able to voltage regulate to 0.01 volts and 0.01 amps. We'll see about that at some time in the future. Minimum display resolution. Oh, it'll show wattage as well. That's something that my smaller one won't do. That's cool. And it'll also show amp hours. That's interesting. 80% efficient. Ripple below 50 millivolts. Wide range of temperatures. I could even use it outdoors in the winter here. The switching frequency it uses is 150 kilohertz, so that shouldn't interfere with any audio tape projects I'm doing. But I should keep it in mind anyway. And maybe do some extra filtering if I need a super clean power supply. Short circuit protection. Well, it's a constant current supply, so... Input reverse connection protection. No. Please install your own diode if you want it. And then here's all the display stuff. I'm going to have to try this at some point, and some point soon, actually, and put it through its paces.
As much as I'm going to save this for another video to play with it, I just want to power it up and make sure it's going to work at all. I hope it should. I hope it will. There's no reason for it not to. We have power. See what it says on the output. Where's the OK button? 5.01. You can't see that. 5.01 volts there. Pretty much 5 volts there. Just like it claims. That's excellent. I'll give that a full shakedown with loads and stuff and ammeters and everything else later, but for right now I'm happy that it works. And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Transit times. The buck converters took 32 days each. The two current toroids in from the same seller took 41 days. These ESP01 modules took 31 days. And the buck boost converter took 42 days. And this was all before the Chinese holiday, before any of the virus stuff or anything else. So that's just, well, I guess some of those extended times may have been related to Christmas rush and stuff like that. I don't know. Anyway, there should be some more good stuff for the stockpile. These guys are just to replace the ones that I used in the Christmas lights project. These ones, I have a project for them in mind. I'm just hoping that I can actually use them. I'm hoping that the wire that will fit through them. We'll see. These ESP01s, like I said before, they're mostly just to keep my options open. But I think I might end up using at least one of them with the 18 mega. And this guy, upcoming video where I'll run it through its paces and test it out. I'm interested to see some of these extra modes on the screen here on the display. And I'm also interested to explore this transmit and receive data pins over here. What else is there to say today? Thanks to my Patreons for helping me finance this stuff. Keep the mailbags rolling in and entertaining everybody else, and keep me with projects to play with and videos to make. Thanks to everybody for watching. comments, questions, concerns, complaints, all the rest of that good stuff down in the comments section as usual. Links to this stuff will be in the description as usual. I will talk to you later.